We will now turn to the third and final phase in the WWC review process, which involves synthesizing and reporting results from the reviewed studies. So after reviewing study findings against the WWC standards, the third and final phase of the review process involves synthesizing and reporting two sets of results. This includes determining which findings are main and supplemental. It also includes determining a research rating for all eligible studies, where those research ratings are based on the strength of the study's research design and its execution. And for those studies that meet standards, the WWC also determines an effectiveness rating based on the evidence of favorable effects from the intervention. The WWC's synthesis and reporting of a study's results is also based on the designation of findings as either main or supplemental. Module 11 in this training series provides additional information about the designation of findings as either main or supplemental, but for our purposes here, main study findings are those that must be reviewed as part of the study review process, and tend to be the full sample finding that is measured closest in time after the intervention is completed, whereas supplemental study findings are only observed if specified in the study review protocol, if the findings are needed to construct a main finding in an outcome domain, or if the findings are needed for the purpose of the review. These findings tend to subgroup findings, findings from time points later than the primary finding, or subscales when the full measure is also reported. For example, if the focus of the review is on English language learners, then supplemental findings might include findings for subgroups of English learners within a given study. Based on the WWC's confidence in the strength of the research design and execution of the design, eligible findings from a study will receive one of three research ratings: meets WWC standards without reservations, meets WWC standards with reservations, or does not meet WWC standards. It is important to remember that many studies will report multiple eligible findings, and each of those main or supplemental findings receives its own research rating. So, this means that different findings from the same study can have different WWC research ratings. And again, recall that these research ratings are based on WWC reviewer assessments of the study's outcome measures and assignments to conditions, and, in some cases, the study's compositional change and baseline equivalence. After the WWC determines research ratings for each main and supplemental finding in a study, the WWC will then also assign a study-level research rating. These study-level research ratings are assigned to the whole study and are based on the research ratings from the findings within that study. To receive a study-level research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations, at least one main finding from the study must be rated meets WWC standards without reservations. To receive a study-level research rating of meets WWC standards with reservations, at least one main or supplemental finding from the study must be rated meets WWC standards with reservations, or at least one supplemental finding meets standards, but all main findings do not meet standards, or the study does not have any main findings. And finally, to receive a study-level research rating of does not meet WWC standards, all main and supplemental findings from the study are rated does not meet WWC standards. Let us walk through an example of how the WWC might determine a study-level research rating from a study that has multiple main and supplemental findings. Let's say the WWC is reviewing evidence from a study that reports findings for four outcome measures that fall within the following eligible outcome domains: academic achievement, algebra, writing quality, and student behavior. Let's assume the findings for academic achievement and algebra are both considered main findings, and the research ratings for these two findings are both does not meet WWC standards. The study also reports results for two supplemental findings. One of the supplemental findings is for a writing quality outcome, and the research rating for that finding is meets WWC standards with reservations. Whereas the supplemental finding for a student behavior outcome has a research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations. At the synthesis and reporting phase of the study review process, the WWC will determine a research rating for this study based on the research ratings from all the findings in the study. In this example, we see that none of the main findings from the study have a research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations. Because of this, we know that the study cannot receive a study-level research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations. Next, we know at least one main or supplemental finding from the study has a research rating of meets WWC standards with reservations, namely the finding for the writing quality outcome. Given this, the study level research rating in this example would be meets WWC standards with reservations. Let us walk through an example of how the WWC might determine a study level research rating from a study that has multiple main and supplemental findings. Let's say the WWC is reviewing evidence from a study that reports findings for four outcome measures that fall within the following eligible outcome domains: academic achievement, algebra, writing quality, and student behavior. Let's assume the findings for academic achievement and algebra are both considered main findings, and the research ratings for these two findings are both does not meet WWC standards. The study also reports results for two supplemental findings. One of the supplemental findings is for a writing quality outcome, and the research rating for that finding is meets WWC standards with reservations. Whereas the supplemental finding for a student behavior outcome has a research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations. At the synthesis and reporting phase of the study review process, the WWC will determine a research rating for this study based on the research ratings from all the findings in the study. In this example, we see that none of the main findings from the study have a research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations. Because of this, we know that the study cannot receive a study-level research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations. The WWC characterizes evidence from individual studies and intervention reports by outcome domain. In the instance where a study reports multiple main findings with an outcome domain, the WWC will synthesize the results of those main findings using a fixed effects meta-analysis approach, which is described in greater detail in Module 11 of this training series. For intervention reports, this approach allows the WWC to combine every effect size in the same outcome domain across all studies that examined the same intervention into a single average that accounts for differences between studies, such as their sample size. Then the WWC provides an effectiveness rating for the intervention for each outcome domain based on the direction of the average effect, its statistical significance, whether the findings are from large samples and multi-site samples, and whether the findings met the WWC standards with or without reservations. The effectiveness ratings for individual studies and intervention reports include strong evidence, or Tier 1, moderate evidence, or Tier 2, promising evidence, or Tier 3, uncertain effects, and negative effects. It is important to note that a study or intervention report cannot be classified as Tier 1 through 3 based on supplemental findings alone. So, in the case where only supplemental findings meet standards, the study or intervention will be classified as showing uncertain effects in that outcome domain. For practice guides, the WWC again characterizes evidence in a similar way as it does with intervention reports, but it also includes information about practitioner experience and the opinions of a panel of nationally recognized experts. So, practice guides provide recommendations that combine the empirical literature alongside expert opinion. The recommendations included in practice guides focus on education strategies and practices, such as example writing strategies or techniques for teaching math to young students, rather than characterizing the evidence for specific branded products or programs. The effectiveness ratings for each practice recommendation in a practice guide are based on the evidence of statistically significant and positive effects for relevant outcome domains. Whether the findings are from large samples and multi-site samples, the research ratings of the findings that meet WWC standards, and relevance to the scope and context of the practice guide recommendation. The WWC assigns effectiveness ratings to practice guide recommendations as supported by strong evidence or Tier 1, moderate evidence or Tier 2, promising evidence or Tier 3, or notes when evidence demonstrates a rationale for a recommendation or Tier 4. Module 11 in this training series will provide additional detail on how the WWC determines these effectiveness ratings. Before moving on to discuss effect sizes, it is important to make a note about the procedures the WWC uses for sending author queries. The WWC reviews studies using information from the primary publicly available study manuscript and any related publicly available documents. But there are many scenarios when the information reported in these materials may be insufficient to complete the WWC review. In these cases, the WWC may send an author query to request more information from the researchers who conducted the study. The WWC will not review findings sent through responses to author queries that are not publicly available, and the WWC will encourage authors to make any unpublished findings publicly available through ERIC. The WWC uses author queries to attempt to gather missing information that is needed to determine the study's eligibility, the WWC research rating in an eligible study, an acceptable effect size estimate, or contextual information such as sample demographics. For example, review teams might query study authors to determine whether the demographics of the study sample meet the eligibility criteria under the study review protocol. However, it is important to note that the WWC does not ask study authors to conduct new analysis. When the WWC conducts an author query, we will summarize the study author's response to the query in the study review notes, and that will then be archived in the study review guide. See Appendix B of the handbook for detailed information about the WWC process for sending author queries.